Good morning, all of you. Now today I am going to start a topic from Unit 3, Basic Principles of Humoral and Cellular Immune Reaction. So, cellular immune और humoral immune response को पढ़ने से पहले हम आइए देखते हैं what is the definition of immunity. Principles of humoral and cellular immune reactions. Here we define definition of immunity. Once again, you can see here other definition of immunity. It is the ability of a human body to resist almost all kinds of organisms and toxins that tends to damage the tissues and organs. इम्यूनिटी क्या है? एक डिफेंस मैकेनिज्म है बॉडी की. जो भी फॉरेन पार्टिकल्स हमारे बॉडीज में इंटर करते हैं उसके अगेंस्ट ये फाइट करता है और हमें उस पाथोजन से बचाता है और तमाम तरह की डिजीज़ों से हमें प्रोटेक्ट करता है. तो ये डिजीज़ कॉज्ड बाय फंगाई, प्रोटोजोवा, बैक्टीरिया एंड वायरसेस, दीज आर ऑल आर पोटेंशियल पाथोजन्स. पाथोजेंस क्या हैं, इसकी डेफिनेशंस एग्जाम में पूछ सकता है. तो दीज आर द एजेंट कॉजेज डिजीजेज दैट इज कॉल्ड पाथोजेंस. नाउ इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स की बात करें तो रिएक्शंस ऑफ द सेल्स एंड फ्लूड्स ऑफ द बॉडी टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ए सब्सटेंस व्हिच इज नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज्ड एज अ कंस्टिट्यूएंट ऑफ द बॉडी इटसेल्फ. नाउ मैकेनिज्म ऑफ इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स you can see here. First is a pre-immune mechanism. Antigens, Ag is represent antigens. Okay, so Ag penetrates tissue, vasodilation or edema, adsorption of the antigens to immune tissue. Immune mechanisms to migrations of APC in the T or B zone, peripheral organs of the immune system. APC इज द एंटीजन प्रेजेंटिंग सेल्स. जो सरफेस पे एंटीजन्स प्रेजेंट होते हैं उनको हम एपीसी से करते हैं. एपीसी का फुल फॉर्म है एंटीजन प्रेजेंटिंग सेल्स. प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ एंटीजन स्टेज फर्स्ट है इंडोसाइटोसिस ऑफ एंटीजन. सेकेंड स्टेज है क्लीवेज या प्रोसेसिंग स्टेज. थर्ड है एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ डिग्रेडेड पार्टिकल्स एंटीजन्स एट द एमटीसी इन द कॉम्प्लेक्स विद एमएससी फर्स्ट एंड एमएससी सेकेंड, जो कि हम फर्दर पढ़ेंगे. एमएससी मेजर हिस्टोकॉम्पैटिबिलिटी कॉम्प्लेक्स फर्स्ट और सेकेंड स्टेज. फेस है प्रेजेंटिंग टू टीएसएल. टीएसएल मींस हेल्पर टी सेल्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट मैकेनिज्म है सेपरेशन ऑफ इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स. ऑटो इम्यून डिजीज कैन रन एंड इम्यूनोलॉजिकल मेमोरी. Now, first line of defense goal to stop pathogens from entering the body. So, these are the barriers such as the skin, which act as a barrier to invasion. Sweat has a chemicals which can kill different pathogens. Tears have lysozyme enzymes which has powerful digestive ability that render antigens harmless. Saliva hai also has a lysozyme. Mucus hai can trap pathogens which are then sneezed, coughed, washed away or destroyed by chemicals. Stomach acid hai destroy pathogens. Now second line of defense. If a pathogen is able to get the body's first line of the defense, suppose that wo first line ko barrier ko cross kar deta hai aur second line defense mein pravesh karta hai, tab kya hota hai? And an infection start. The body can rally on its second line of defense. First, there is a non-specific response, phagocytosis, followed by an inflammatory responses. Phagocytosis is equal to ingestion plus digestion of pathogens. Now, cell-mediated immunity is a type of immunity when bodies develops large number of lymphocytes which are specifically activated against foreign agents. These activated or sensitized lymphocytes have the ability to attach the foreign agent and destroy it. Cellular immunity, which is represented by CI. CI is a composed of sensitized T lymphocytes. Now, in process of developing of CL phagocytic cells involved in the expulsion of pathogens from the intercellular space, phagocytic cells attack pathogens and destroy them. On intracellular levels, macrophages are the main cells protectors which have a specific receptors IgE through which they affect on the pathogen. It aims to combine phagocytosis and specific antibodies to fight pathogenic environment. Now, cells involved in cellular immunities, these are T lymphocyte cells, macrophage cells or NK cells, natural killer cells, type of CTL. Macrophages present antigens via their surface of MSC to cells. T cells recognize antigens through the specific receptors and specific T cells clone becomes activated and begins to proliferate. Activate Th lymphocytes become effectors cells that secrete cytokines. You can see here AG processing and presentation. Protein pathogens processed and converted into peptide to bind major histocompatibility complex molecules on APC to be present on T cells. You can see here infected cells and antigen fragments, class of MSC molecules, T cells receptors, antigens associated with MSC molecules, T cells recognizes combination, cytotoxic cells formed. Microbes are engulfed, antigen presenting cells here present, antigens fragments, class MSC second molecules, T cells and helper cells develop. Now you can see here MSC class first all nucleated cells and MSC class second B cells APC macrophages they attest at the surface. Now T cells activation. TS cells means T helper cells express IL-2, leukotrienes 2 receptors and secrete cytokines include IL-2, matlab interleukotrienes. IL-2 auto activate TS cells, APC released leukotrienes first, which acts on both APC and helper cells to promote their activation. All mentioned interactions lead to activations of mature TS cells. Mature T cells proliferate and differentiate into effectors, antigens, specific T cells releasing cytokines. Some of them become a memory cells which provide a secondary immune response. Cytokines released from activated T cells activate macrophages, NK cells and B cells. Now activated CD8 cells proliferate and differentiate into a clone of effector cells, CTLs. Effector of CTLs kills target cells, nucleated cells infected with virus, tumor cells or graft cells. MSC class first all nucleated cell and MSC second cell B cells APC macrophages. Now activated TH cells secretes interferon gamma which activates macrophages and increases their ability to kill ingested intracellular pathogens. IFN means interferon. This process of activation of macrophages, NK cells and cytotoxic T cells infiltrations and proliferations of inflammatory cells stimulated by cytokines released from TS cells is important protective mechanisms against intracellular pathogens. Now, cytokines stimulates other effector cells of CMI and humoral immune responses and mediate the following: attack monocytes, macrophages and lymphocytes to the sites and activate macrophages to kill intracellular microbes. Promote activity of CD-CTLs which directly kill virus infected cells, tumor cells and graft rejections. They activate NK cells, natural killer cells, increasing their cytotoxic function. Stimulate B cells to differentiate into plasma cells that secretes antibodies. Third line of defense. Sometimes the second line of defense is still not enough, and the pathogen is then heading for the body's last line of defense. The immune system recognizes, attacks, destroys, and remembers each pathogen that enters the body. It does this by making specialized antibodies that render the pathogens harmless. For each type of pathogens, the immune system produces cells that are specific for that particular pathogens. Now, next is humoral immunity. The humoral response is carried out by antibodies which are produced by plasma cells. Plasma cells are derived from activated B cells that are produced in the bone marrow. In the bone marrow, they mature. Humoral immunity promotes the developing of normal operations antibodies. The aim of bacteria and virus or cancer pathogens is to enter the cells to destroy it. The principle of action of antibody is the interruptions of receptors linkage between the pathogens and the cells. Antibodies क्या करती है? Break करती है pathogens और cell के बीच में जो भी linkage है. The result is to break down of interaction between the pathogens and cells due to blocking it by the effector molecules or antibodies. Now, what is the antibodies? You can see here, antibodies is a protein produced by B cells that is used by the immune system to identify and neutralize the foreign objects such as the bacteria and viruses and prevents from the diseases. Agglutinations enhance phagocytosis and reduce number of infectious units to be dealt with. Opsonization is coating antigens with antibody, enhance the phagocytosis. Neutralization means blocks the additions of bacteria and viruses to mucosa, also blocks a active site of toxins. Activations of complement. Inflammation means disruption of cells by complement or C-reactive proteins attack phagocytes and other defensive immune system cells. AB-dependent cells mediated cytotoxicity. Antibodies attached to a target cells cause destructions by non-specific immune cells. Now you can see here in a chart form given the mechanism or functions of antibodies. You can see here neutralization of microbes, opsonization and phagocytosis of microbes, antibody dependent cellular toxicity, phagocytosis of microbes opsonized with a complement fragment, inflammation, lysis of microbes and complement activations. These are the functions of antibodies. Now come on topic immunoglobulins and classifications of immunoglobulins. Antibodies is also known as immunoglobulins. So these are five types. IgG, the most common, represents 75-80% of serum immunoglobulin, the only antibodies capable of crossing the placenta to give the passive immunity to the fetus. This is the important line which immunoglobulins can cross the placenta, that is IgG. The only antibodies capable of crossing the placenta to give passive immunity to the fetus. It has a longest half-life, 23 days, among of all the immunoglobulins, activate complement, stimulate chemotaxis. Now next hai IgD, antigens receptors on surface B cells, together with IgM, activate basophils and mast cells to produce antimicrobial factors. You can see here, this is in a Y shape. Here is Ig, variable light chains and constant light chains hinge region hai. And next one is IgD, antigen receptor surface B cells together with IgM activate basophils and mast cells to produce antimicrobial activity. Next hai IgE, bound to surface of mast cells and basophils, destroy parasitic worms and participates in allergies. So this immunoglobulin IgE is responsible or play important role in allergies. This is also important. Now IgE, present in body secretion, provides protection against proliferation of microorganisms in this fluid. It's in the defense against microbes and foreign molecules penetrating the body via cell linings of these cavities. Provides passive immunity to infants through a mother's breast milk. This is the important line. Provides passive immunity to infants through mother breast milk. That is IgE, immunoglobulin. Now IgM is the first Ig class produced in a primary response to an antigen found on surface of B cells. Antigens receptors of B cells has 10 antigens binding sites, more effective at stimulating complement. The Fc receptors of on phagocytes bind IgM. Stem cells of immunoglobulins, that is Fc receptors binding site. Now, what is the interference are proteins made and released by the host cells in response to the presence of pathogens such as a virus, bacteria, parasites or tumor cells. They allow for a communication between cells to trigger the protective defense of the immune system that eradicate pathogens or tumors. Gamma interferons are produced by NK cells, natural killer cells that activate macrophages, type 2 interferon. NK cells, then gamma interferons, macrophage activations, whereas alpha and beta interferons are produced by virus infected cells that activate NK cells, type 1 interferon cells. Virus infected cells, alpha, beta interferons and natural killer cells activations. Now complement system kya hai? The complement system helps the ability of antibody and phagocytic cells to clear pathogens from an organism. It is part of the innate immune system, not adaptive, doesn't changes during the lifetime. The complement system consists of a number of small proteins found in the blood, in general synthesized by the liver, and normally circulates as the inactive precursors. When stimulated by one of several triggers, proteases in the system cleavage specific proteins to release cytokines and initiate an amplifying cascade of further cleavages. Now humoral immunity, you can see here in diagram, microorganisms carry T dependent antigens and antigens fragment, then self MSC molecules, antigens fragment hai, then macrophages. The microbial antigens ingested by an APC and partially digested. Fragments from the microbes and bind with MSC second to form a MSC second oblique AG complex on the surface of the APC. TS cells specific for the presented antigens binds to the MSC second AG complex. TSS then activates on appropriate B cells by releasing interleukins 2 to it, and IL-2 growth factor for T and B cells. The interactions between the TS cells and B cells causes the B cells to differentiate into plasma cells and memory cells. You can see here antigens, receptors, beta cells, interleukins 2 secretes, and plasma cells then secreted antibodies. Memory cells role is to identify, and plasma cells role is to produce or secrete antibodies. Now, memory cells do not react right away but are held in reserve for later infections. The secondary response that is carried out by memory cells is different in three ways. Memory cells produce antibodies that bind with a greater affinity to their antigens than the antibodies produced in the initial response. The response time is much faster than the primary response. A greater number of antibodies are produced. Memory B cells and antibodies produces a memory T cells is an infectious fighting cells. Now completed, I have completed about immune types of immune response.